planets like the Earth orbits around large masses such as the Sun. According to Kepler's first law, planetary orbits are elliptic. Newton then proposed the inverse square law of universal gravitation. In this video, let's do the opposite. Assuming Newton's inverse square law is true, let's prove that the shape of orbits are conic sections. Firstly, we start off with Newton's second law of fixed masses, F equals ma. By the inverse square law, F is equal to minus big G times the mass of the Earth times the mass of the Sun divided by the distance squared in the direction from the Sun to the Earth, hence the unit vector in this equation. Let's also write A as the second derivative of the position vector R. We can cancel off the m, and we are left with this equation. Let's first write the vector r in the polar form, with length r and angle theta. The vector cos theta sine theta will be referred to as r hat from now on, which is the unit vector of r. Let's write vector r as r times r hat. Then we can apply the product rule twice and obtain this expression. There are several vectors in this expression, the second derivative of r hat, the derivative of r hat, and r hat. Let's compute these vectors explicitly. First, let's compute the derivative of r hat, which is the derivative of cos theta sine theta. Applying the chain rule, we get d theta dt minus sine theta cos theta. We can then differentiate this expression with respect to t again to obtain the second derivative of r hat. We apply the product rule again, and then the chain rule, and we finally obtain the vectors as shown. We see two different vectors here, cos theta sine theta and minus sine theta cos theta. The first one we have already called r hat. Let's call the other one r perp hat, which is perpendicular to r hat. Now we can rewrite the original equation in terms of r hat and r perp hat. We can rearrange this expression into a linear combination of these two vectors. Since the two vectors are linearly independent, i.e. in different directions on the 2D plane, their coefficients must be both zero. So now we have two equations for us to solve. We want the final expression relating theta and r without t. Let's deal with the second equation first. We can multiply by r on both sides to get this equation, which, by the product rule, is just the derivative of r squared d theta dt. Thus, the second equation gives us that r squared d theta dt is a constant, which is actually the conservation of angular momentum. We can now use this to eliminate t in the first equation. Firstly, we can replace d theta dt as c over r squared. And then we can write the second term more explicitly as a double derivative and apply the chain rule. After applying the chain rule, we can replace d theta dt as c over r squared to completely eliminate t. Simplifying, we get this expression. Since 1 over r appears frequently, let's introduce the substitution u equals 1 over r. Let's cancel some common factors too. By implicit differentiation, the derivative of u inverse with respect to theta is just minus 1 over u squared du d theta. The u squareds cancel out, and we can bring the minus sign out of the differential operator and simplify the notation as a second derivative. We divide both sides by c squared. We will now rewrite this equation into a familiar differential equation, the second derivative of u plus u minus gm over c squared equals 0. Since the derivatives of constants are 0 anyway, we can rewrite the second derivative of u as the second derivative of u minus gm over c squared. This, by my previous video, can be solved. We finally get u minus gm over c squared equals a cosine theta minus phi. Rearranging and plugging back u equals 1 over r, we get that r is equal to c squared over gm over 1 plus a c squared over gm cosine theta minus phi. There are many constants here. Let's rewrite two of them as c and e. We now have a familiar form of a conic section, as mentioned in my previous video. Therefore, orbits are conic sections. If they are parabole or hyperbole, the planet will travel in a direction of no return. Hence, the orbits we can observe today must be elliptic.